Hello, fabulous Libra. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of May 2020. Looking at life and love, I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. It is going to be this month that your ruling planet, Venus, will go retro in the middle of the month. Now, I did speak all about this in the Venus retrograde special horoscope, and I will link to that below. But I did want to mention it now because even though a whole lot of us are going to be feeling quite reflective by the time we get to the middle of the month with fully four planets retrograde, it is going to be that much more the case for you. And even though this Venus retrograde season this month is kind of confusing, a little bit wonky, it is going to feel that much more the case for you. So the important thing to remember is self-care as a primary goal for you or practice. At the same time, with this Venus retrograde taking place in such a worldly part of the sky, a part of the sky that is all about reaching out to the world, engaging the world, and with so much of us practicing some type of social distancing, it may feel as if that desire is unable to be met, the more adventurous spirit. But delays are not denials. That is truly your mantra for this month. That whatever it is that feels like you'd like it to come together, that you'd like to have that experience right now, know that that is there for you. But with a time like this, sometimes the universe can have a timetable of its own, and the best way through it is to flow with it. There are going to be other things, celestial events, lunar events happening this month that are also going to be notable. Right around the 7th of the month, we will have this month's full moon. This full moon is happening in a part of the sky for you that has to do with self-esteem and self-worth, but it is also connected in more practical ways to things like money you earn and money that you spend. Now, this full moon will be speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune. In and of itself, I do love this energy. It is magical. It is hopeful. It is also going to be Mercury standing across the sky from this full moon. So I actually think that could work in your favor because this is going to ask you to communicate, to check in with yourself, and to negotiate as well. Now, if you are one of the many people out there who is looking at or trying to access funding of some kind, well, it may very well be at this time that you're feeling as if you have to go back and forth between you and a financial institution. That's because that's where Mercury's moving through. However, it is going to feel as if there is the money you need, and certainly the opportunity to earn money can come together for you in ways that may feel like they touch on magic. Still, because the overall energy, not only with this full moon, but also with Venus, isn't necessarily very grounded, isn't necessarily very practical, it does suggest a need to maintain practicality at this time, especially with things like your finances, and especially with things like ensuring that you are seeing yourself in the most loving way. As we navigate later into the month, right around the 22nd is when we will have this month's new moon. Now, that new moon will be happening in the same part of the sky that Venus will be retrograde in by this point. Now, what I do love about this new moon, though, is that it is speaking in supreme harmony with Saturn. There is a stabilizing and successful energy at this time, but it's also patience towards an end. It is taking a mature approach that is rewarded. And so for you, this may be a very practical decision around what you need to put into place so that you can manifest bigger and better in the fullness of time. Perhaps you're looking at higher education. Perhaps it is that you are looking at what experiences you'd like to have. Maybe it is you exploring matters of politics or philosophy. Now, regardless, it does look like this new moon promises a new beginning of sorts, the kind that truly helps root you towards a stronger future. Now, where it comes to matters of love, in addition to the Venus retrograde season, we also have Saturn standing still in the sky, going retro mid-month as well. And it is Saturn that has just stepped into, giving you a little bit of a sneak peek into this larger transit that you're going to more fully step into at the end of the year. Well, this is Saturn in a part of the sky for you that has to do with flirtation and romance and what the heart truly desires. With that change of direction, it is going to be that you will be one of the signs most likely to feel that sense of needing to be honest with yourself about love, about what your heart wants, about whom it is that you feel your heart is moving you towards, and what the reality of the situation is. So if it is that you are open to meeting someone new, what a contrast of energies we have here. On the one hand, that Venus retrograde season is overly dreamy, not grounded at all, even confusing. And then we have this energy that says, be honest, be practical, look at what it is that you are being shown. Now, if you're open to meeting someone new, some of these lessons may very well show up in terms of someone that you may meet at this time, but certainly you will be reflecting more deeply on yourself, where you've been, and what needs to change so that you can move yourself in the direction you desire to go. For those of you who are just starting to date somebody, I do think that for you, this is one of those very consequential moments. It is a very all or nothing kind of energy, especially given that Saturn will stand still mid-month and go retrograde. And this is going to be an opportunity for you to get honest with yourself about what you are drawn to in this person. What is it that brings you to this moment, and whether or not you truly feel authentically connected. And for those of you who are in an established bond, it can be a powerful time, but not the time to be making commitments or very solid plans. A great time to dream, certainly. And if you wanted to make plans, I would say the days around the new moon could be okay. However, because Venus is connecting with Neptune all month, in a conversation of tension, there's a sense that plans you do make, while there may be some very key details that are being overlooked. But for all that, this can be a time when you actually find great security, great comfort in the bond that you share with your partner, feeling like that is enough to know that you will continue to move forward and navigate this time, as you surely will. But to navigate this time of uncertainty with a sense of faith and love is the superpower and the strength of this time. What I love about this month for you, well, there's a lot here, but I'm going to say that full moon in the early part of the month, that is a moon of hope, a moon of prosperity. Yes, there is some negotiation involved. There may very well be paperwork or documents, but when we have such strong financial energy, it means that the money you need is there. And as long as you are balancing the more confusing energy with the more practical, it can be amazing how you find the resources you need, the things that you need. They come together for you now in the most remarkable and sometimes faithful ways. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to nadiashaw.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive video scopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes, including the Venus retrograde special horoscopes for your sign, and so much more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.